let's go over what we've got with regards to virtual environment in this course. We have four VMs that we have access to: PySRV01, PySRV02, PySQL01, and PyInt01. There is a SQL server, a Microsoft SQL server, installed on SQL01, a OPC server on PyInt01, a Py interface on PyInt01, and a data archive on PySRV01. So we've got those pre-installed, they're all set up, they're all working. We also have the network load balancer. The network load balancer is called PyAF, and it redirects traffic on the asset framework ports to PySRV01 and PySRV02. We'll use that much later in the class when we're configuring highly available architectures. What are we doing in this class? So we start with a fairly bare bones system and a really badly configured system. It's not secure. It's not even using the best practices we went over in the basics class. So here's our plan. We're going to secure our interface. Right now we have the read-write version of the interface installed. We're going to replace that with the read-only version. We're going to allow authentication cross-domain. We're going to install asset framework on PySRV01, connecting to PySQL01 as a backend SQL server. We're going to install a secondary PyData archive and AF server on PySRV02. We're going to configure the data archive to be a redundant pair and the AF servers to be a redundant pair. There's a few differences to what we're doing here than what we do in real life. So we're not going to cover interface redundancy in this course. We already covered it in the basics course. We're going to just assume we have interface redundancy. So we'll talk about how it works when interacting with the other parts, like highly available Py data archives, but we're not going to do any exercise on it in this class. We have a single SQL server in our architecture here. In real life, you'd actually have a highly available, redundant, at least a redundant pair of SQL servers. We're not really going to cover that, but the configuration on the Py side is exactly the same, really no matter what our SQL setup is. We'll get into depth a little more on that later. The other difference is that we're still assuming you have a fairly small Py system. The architecture we're using in this class, a lot of the components are shared on a server. So as you can see, the asset framework and data archive are on the same server in both our primary and secondary machines. In real life, we'd really separate these out, but we're going to talk about when to add more servers and when to separate services out a little later in the course. And with that, feel free to move on. Let's do the configuration.